Sheila E., how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
Let me first ask you, are you wearing some stiletto flats?
Stiletto flats. Yes, I am. It's all this walking? No.
That's right.
I am not wearing heels today.
Jump right in. Tell everybody what.
Sit here and be cute.
Tell everybody what stiletto flats are about and how you came about creating them.
Yeah, Stiletto Flats is my record company, and I'm known for wearing heels and high heels, but I can also rock some flat shoes when I need to. Yeah.
Those are fabulous with the jewels and everything.
Thank you.
Are they available right away? I could get a pair just like
yet.
That?
Not yet.
Soon, though, right?
Soon. Soon.
You know, Sheila, I saw you perform like a couple years ago, and you was hitting those drums, and then when you kicked them over, I said, gosh, she's going to tear the drums up. She's going to hurt herself. So it's crazy that I was reading that you got hurt. You got injured.
I get injured a lot, but it's all right. It's part of the game. I do what I got to do.
So it was your heel and your Achilles?
Yeah, I fell. Actually, I fell twisted my ankle. Yeah, so it took about a year and a half. I just started wearing heels four months ago.
Are you
serious?
Yeah,
it was a year and a half of no heels.
Wow.
So I got used to it.
Yeah, because I mean, you put on a heck of a show, but Lord, you sacrificed yourself for that show.
Well, I'm going to do it again tonight. So
I know that's right.
That's right.
Sheila E., let me ask you. So many of us, we play our air percussion, air guitar and all that. What's the secret to being a good drummer? Even on the congas or something, because we're always like this. You see us all. Any song. We think we can play, but we can't.
You know what? Just have fun with it, really. It's my passion. It's my gift. So it's different. But, man, if you want to just play and enjoy yourself and air drum, I started on pots and pans.
No.
No, I did. Yeah. I have a slew of regular, like, things from the house and from the garage and tools that I use for percussion.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. No, you got to see the other stuff.
Like, still to this day that you still beat on?
So the Michael Jackson song, Off the Wall album, the song Don't Stop Till You Get Enough.
Yeah.
If you hear those, dun, 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 that's me playing bottle. I put water
what?
In bottles.
No,
I put water in the bottles, and I took the steel part that I play the triangle with, and I tuned it to the song because Michael wanted something percussive, but, you know, Quincy didn't know what he wanted. I was like, hold on, I got it. Let's pour some water in some glass bottles. And when you hear it now, that's me playing water bottles.
So is that typical, you guys, when you're creating music, that you want to have some different sounds for an instrument that traditionally...
I do. I don't know about everybody. Yeah, no, I've used a hairbrush.
Oh, my goodness.
I use a spatula. I've used biting an apple to sample it to make the snare drum sound crispy.
What?
I'm telling my secrets, but yeah.
Oh, this is good. This is the good
awesome.
Part of this.
This is awesome. I love this.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, no, the thing about us creating and doing things is a lot of times we say there's things that we can't do. We put ourselves in a box. There's nothing that says that I can't use other things and create. There's so many things that you can just MacGyver and put together and figure out, man, this is really makes music, you know? And so I decided when I first started to just create and nothing, like I don't use the normal microphones a lot of times for my vocals. I don't use the same microphones for my drums. I use the kick drum mic to sing the sound different. Nobody says I got to do this this way. This is my way.
Yeah.
That's dope. That's dope.
So that's why I'm still here.
That's right.
That's right.
You still doing it. So are you working on some new music?
I do. It's coming out. The first single is coming out in August. It's called No Line with Snoop Dogg. So it'll be fun.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Give me one of the secrets that you did on that song.
Say it again?
I said, give me one of the secrets that you did on that song. Did you use something out of the garage?
Oh, I did. I can't tell you yet.
Can't tell us yet?
I'll tell you when we start doing those interviews for that song.
All right, we love it.
It's worth a try.
Well, Sheila E., you fit right in the Essence Festival of Culture. You are a part of our culture, a significant part of our culture. And we love and appreciate you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. See y'all tonight.